Milton.
Yes, Ndogo.
Why do we have these problems of, you know, legitimacy, for example? I mean, here yes. you are. You have two gentlemen who happen yes. to be citizens of the Democratic Republic of the Congo, who come yes. from different parts of the Congo, who actually agree mm-hmm. that the Banyamulenge are legitimate Congolese citizens. Any particular reason, yes. any particular reason why they are being chased out or killed simply because somebody suggests that they are quote-unquote immigrants?
Well, you know, Shaka, it's so tragic that we are sitting here in the 21st century, in 2019, discussing issues of ethnicity, issues of legitimacy, when these should be citizens of Africa, citizens of East Africa. And to be honest, as we know, this is not a unique problem to the Congo. It's not unique to the Banyamulenge being targeted. We've seen issues of ethnicity abused by politicians all over the African continent. And in fact, it was primarily the reason for what we saw in Rwanda, the genocide, in 1994, when initially Rwanda was invaded from Uganda in 1990, and that caused the ethnic tension between Hutu and Tutsi to escalate. And mind you, these are citizens of Africa, citizens of supposedly one country, Rwanda. But because of the direction in which politicians steered those issues, after the assassination, the double assassination of the president in 1994, we saw the most horrific killings by neighbors, by friends, by people that went to school together, people that worked together. And then it spilled into the Congo after the primarily Hutu government was defeated. And then there, we also saw retribution against Banyamulenge, and then we also saw retribution against Hutu, and now the whole region is gripped in that ethnic tension, vice, and horrific atrocities. Part of it is because politicians abuse the situation for their own agenda, and part of it is, of course, competition over resources, over land, over livestock, over access to minerals.
Hold it there.
Shaka, remember what Ndugu Mwalimu Nyerere said. Nyerere said, if we have larger African federations and ultimately a United States of Africa, which Nkrumah also spoke about, we would not have to deal with these kind of issues. We would be dealing with bigger issues, how to create jobs in Africa and how to dispense and disperse and contribute resources to all the citizens, either of East Africa or of Africa. But when we keep it focused on Hutu, Tutsi, Banyamulenge, and the rest of the Congolese, that's why we're sitting and discussing this today, a conversation we should not even be having. It's very tragic.